My book is A Light in the Attic by Shel Silverstein. It was banned in 1985 by an elementary school in Wisconsin because it encourages children to break dishes so they don't have to dry them. The poem in question is called How Not to Have to Dry the Dishes. If you have to dry the dishes, such an awful boring chore. If you have to dry the dishes instead of going to the store. If you have to dry the dishes and to drop one on the floor, maybe they won't let you dry the dishes anymore. I love Shel Silverstein's poems because they look at life through the perspective of a child. Something as simple as, well, maybe if I don't do my chores quite so right, I won't have to do them anymore, to more serious thoughts, like the poem, The Little Boy and the Old Man. Said the little boy, sometimes I drop my spoon. Said the little old man, I do that too. The little boy whispered, I wet my pants. I do that too, laughed the little old man. Said the little boy, I often cry. The old man nodded, so do I. But worst of all, said the boy, it seems grown-ups don't pay attention to me. And he felt the warmth of a wrinkled old hand. I know what you mean, said the little old man. Or a poem like Hinges. If we had hinges on our heads, there wouldn't be no sin, because we could take the bad stuff out and leave the good stuff in. And he has lots of serious poems sprinkled in with poems that encourage imagination and looking at things differently and just wondering what if. Poems like The Man in the Iron Pale Mask. He's the man in the iron pale mask. He can do the most difficult task. He can duel, he can joust, he can charge, he can chase. He can climb, he can rhyme, he can wrestle and race. He'll show you his courage, but never his face, no matter how often you ask. He's the brave and the fearless, the usually tearless man in the iron pale mask. Or looking at fairy tales or just common stories in another way, like In Search of Cinderella. From dusk to dawn, from town to town without a single clue, I seek the tender, slender foot to fit this crystal shoe. From dusk to dawn, I try it on each damsel that I meet. And I still love her so, but oh, I've started hating feet. In short, Shel Silverstein's books are clever, funny, and meant to be read with the mindset of a child.